Very good evening, everyone. My name is Shubham Singhania, and I'm your mentor for UGC NET Paper 1, Paper 2 Commerce and Management. So today I have a very, very special guest. She is Ms. Navya Bagda. She has recently got selected at two prestigious institutes, that is XLRI Jamshedpur and IIT Delhi. So aap sabke dimag mein ek bahut basic question rehta hai ki sir, agar hamare paas experience nahi hai, agar humne sirf अभी रिसेंटली मास्टर्स कंप्लीट करी है सो हमें किस तरीके से प्रिपेयर करना चाहिए, व्हाट शुड बी आवर स्ट्रेटजी. सो टुडे आई हैव अ रियल टाइम एक्सपीरियंस, लाइव एक्सपीरियंस इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू. शी इज एन एग्जांपल सेटर, जिससे आपको पता चलेगा दैट हाउ डिड शी एक्चुअली प्रिपेयर्ड एंड व्हाट आर द वेरियस एस्पेक्ट्स जिनका आपको ध्यान रखना है इफ यू आर अ फ्रेशर एंड इफ यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर सच प्रेस्टिजियस इंस्टीट्यूट. सो वेलकम नव्या, आई होप दैट a lot of learnings would be taken from your experience by our dear subscribers as well as our students. So welcome and heartiest congratulations once again.
Thank you so much, sir, for inviting me and making me a source of helping people and guiding them.
Okay, thank you so much, Navya. Navya, my first question to you is, how does it feel to get selected at two of the prestigious institutes, even when you were a fresher?
Obviously, sir, it's a great feeling. And while I was just preparing for my UGC NET exam, so I used to like watch all your live videos, which used to be up at 7 p.m. and then like coming here and getting interviewed by you. So it's just been a pleasure.
Okay, thank you so much, Navya. I'm sure ki it would have been a very challenging task because you were preparing for NET also, and then you cracked the PhD at these two prestigious institutes. I'm sure ki you must have put a lot of hard work and lot of commitment.
Yes, sir.
Okay, Navya, that brings me to the next question, that tell us something about your educational qualifications, that what all you have done in your graduation, post-graduation, and how and when did you clear your NET exam and all?
So basically, I have graduation economics from University of Delhi. And after that, I've done my post-graduation in MCOM from Delhi School of Economics, University of Delhi itself. And while I was in the third semester of my college, I started preparing with the UGC NET exam. And so I cracked the GRF exam with a score of 99.73 in the very first attempt.
Wonderful. That is amazing. 99.73 is certainly a very, very good score. And I'm sure that might have helped you prepare a lot of stuff in terms of how do you get to know about what are the topics such as HR topics. So I think HR to wahin se complete ho gaya hoga.
Yes, sir. Yes, it was of a great help. I would say preparing simultaneously just after like I cleared the NET exam. So I just went through the PhD process. Great. So ultimately it just bridged the gap.
Wonderful. Navya, that brings me to the next question, that when and how did you actually start with your PhD preparation? Kab start kiya, kab dimag mein aaya ki now it's the right time to prepare, and how did you actually start?
Yes, sir. So while I was in, I just completed the first year of my post-graduation, so I was very keen on pursuing a PhD program. But I first wanted to make sure that I clear the NET exam. And after clearing the NET exam, just after taking a month or two, maybe when the results were declared, so I just went ahead with the PhD process, which was in the fourth semester of my college. Because I believe that, you know, once you're in touch with your academics, it ultimately helps you to understand the process in a much precise manner. And right. It was then when I decided to finally take up the PhD.
Wonderful. So basically, the moment you cleared your UGC NET JRF, you started with your PhD preparation. Right, Navya?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Navya, now tell me, because students' dimag mein ye bahut hi common question rehta hai. They also keep asking me that, sir, what are the various sources that we can freely pick up to start our preparations for PhD? So, कुछ sources के बारे में बताइए नव्या.
Yes, sir. So, for me, my post-graduation books were like Bhagavad Gita to me, because these were the books that ultimately actually helped me to brush up my skills. And also, thanks to my college professors, because they actually developed a habit, they inculcated a habit of reading research papers, interpreting them in a very precise manner. So, it's very important to first to develop a habit of reading research papers. Plus, I would say to decide on a topic, to narrow down on a topic, it is equally important to go through all the literature review. And for that, I mainly use Google Scholar, and I also use an extension Paper Panda, because some of the research papers were not actually easily accessible to me. So I used this particular extension on Chrome. Apart from that, I refer to many of the YouTube videos, and also I used to just read some of the blogs and the articles on the upcoming trends that are recently there in HR and OB.
Wonderful. So I can see you have been a avid reader, reading a lot of stuff, be it research papers, be it your books of post-graduation, or be it a lot of blogs. So I think usse bahut madad mil gayi hogi, because you must have got to know that what are the emerging trends, what are the emerging issues in the area of HR and OB.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now that brings me to the next question, and this is a very critical question, that how did you actually prepare your research proposal or statement of purpose?
So basically what I figured out that every college was demanding a research proposal. So I basically made a draft of about 500 words of a research paper, of the research paper, of the research proposal. So the mainly draft was of 500 words. And then as per the institution requirement, I molded my SOP accordingly. And while I was just going through the process, and when I gave an interview, and after the process got interview for any particular institute, I used to introspect, used to make changes, and my father also helped me a lot in editing the passage and the SOP. Apart from that, I would just stress upon 5 to 6 major points that I believe that should be included in an SOP and according to my understanding. So the first is the introduction part, where you just briefly write about yourself, your background, and then you come up with the why do you want to pursue PhD, the motivation behind you pursuing PhD. Right. And the third is the particular domain in which you want to pursue PhD. For example, my particular domain of interest was HR and OB. Mm-hmm. So this was the third major point that I focused upon. And you can also write about something specific in HR and OB that you have an interest upon, for example, leadership, motivation. So very, very briefly, that depends on you. And then also how your educational background, for example, my educational background was a combination of economics and commerce. So my how my background would eventually help me to understand my research topic in a much better way, and how it will be aligned in the future. Apart from that, lastly, I would stress upon why do you want to pursue PhD from that particular institute? So this is the last point that you should end your SOP with.
Right. So I think you have rightly put up all the important points that need to be considered in statement of purpose. Now talking about research proposal, Navya, so what are the various aspects that need to be taken care of, and how do you actually proceed with research proposal, or how did you actually proceed in terms of your research proposal? Give us some highlights about that.
Yes, sir. So while I was deciding on how should I proceed with writing a research proposal, so I wanted to take a topic that was very much in its nascent stage, that was not much of saturated. So I went through all the research, I would say research papers. I made an Excel sheet where I used to write all the inferences that I draw from that a particular research paper, the author name, the journal name, the year in which it was published, and the journal category. So when I was drawing inferences, I found some of the research gaps in a particular topic. And so this was how that I decided that I will be taking up the topic further. Plus, like after every interview that I used to give, I used to make certain changes after introspecting the whole process.
Wonderful. So one thing that I see very common in all those students who are getting selected, that they're very systematic about things. So generally, kya hota hai ki students 15-20 din pehle start karte hain. They just copy paste things from one or two research papers, do char literature review dal dete hain, and they just submit the research proposal. And the obvious reason is that they do not get selected. But if you are going through a systematic process, jahan aap literature review bhi kar rahe hain, you are creating an Excel sheet, making a list of everything that you have read, I think that makes the process more simpler, because when you are writing it, you already have everything written in terms of Excel sheet. Aapko sirf usko proper layout deke story form mein coherence dekhte hue likhna hai. So I think that is going to be very helpful. Is that so, Navya? Was it helpful?
Yes, sir. Totally agree.
Wonderful.
Totally, sir.
Now that brings me to the next question, and a very important question, because post you have qualified your NET JRF and you have reached the final interview stage, these are the things that are going to be helpful for the students. So how was your interview experience, and what are the kind of questions asked? That means whether the questions are from research background, statistics background, or they are from the core area, that is whether from the research proposal or from the basic HROB topic. How was it? Tell us something about that.
Yes, sir. So specifically, like if I say about IIT Delhi, so it was a 5 to 7 minutes interview, not more than that. And that was the most challenging part because in a very short span of time, you need to make an impression in front of the panelists. And so the interview just started with a very brief introduction about myself and my motivation behind pursuing PhD. Then the interview just went ahead with me describing the research topic, the research area that I had submitted in my SOP. And then I was asked questions regarding the literature review that I just conducted and any theory that I could relate. And this one particular question that I was expecting, that since I have a background of economics at my graduation level, so how my background would actually help me to align my interest with my particular topic of interest. And then just certain basic questions, I think statistics and research methodology, they are actually asked everywhere. And so this was also the focus area, like how would I carry on with my research topic. Then the interview just ended on a very like pleasant note, and how those 5-7 minutes just passed by, I never got to know.
Right. So I think 5-7 minutes तो बहुत ज़्यादा होते भी नहीं है, because इतने कम time के अंदर 3-4 लोगों के panel को impress करना might have taken a lot of reading and a lot of understanding in terms of your own area and proposal. So I think you did a commendable job, Navya. And now coming to the XLRI interview, how was that? Tell us something about that as well.
Yes, sir. So the XLRI interview was totally opposite. So here at IIT Delhi, it was the shortest interview, and at XLRI, it was the longest interview that I'd ever given. It was a 30-minute interview. Oh, wow. And in the first 12 minutes, we had to prepare a PPT, and it was strictly mentioned in the guidelines that the PPT should not be more than 6. It should not be more than 6 slides. Okay. So we had to be very, very precise. And the major areas that I focused upon was basically the introduction part, the literature review part, the conclusion, the future implications, and my research objective and questions. Then in the last 18 minutes, that was the most challenging part, because after you have given your presentations, the panelists, they did ask me certain questions regarding the topic that I'd chosen, the idea that I'd actually presented. So you had to defend our topic and why, and you have to be very, very confident in what you say and how you say it. Right. So this was the challenging part over there in the last 18 minutes. Those were the most crucial time, I would say.
Wonderful. So Navya, my next question is that were all the questions inclined only towards your proposal or HROB area, or were they inclined towards statistics and research as well?
I would say the questions were not very, very specific as such, that only from a particular domain I was asked questions. So according to my understanding, there should be focus on 4 particular areas. The firstly is the motivation questions, the background questions. They were asked almost everywhere. And the second, I would say the subject specific questions. For example, my area was HR and OB. So the questions pertaining to the basic concepts of HR and OB. And the third is the research methodology questions, the statistics questions. Right. And in some institutions, they do ask for a specific topic of interest, like in XLRI and IIT Delhi, they did ask. So the fourth area I would stress upon is that only.
Wonderful.
The research topic questions.
Wonderful. So all of these 4 have to be prepared thoroughly if you want to get into these top premier institutes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, my next question to you is that somebody who's preparing for the PhD interview, apart from these 4 segments, apart from these 4 areas, what should be the depth or level of understanding that he should be carrying up when he's presenting himself in the PhD interview?
I would not say, like, me being a complete fresher, I think it is also not expected of me that I would be having a very high level of knowledge in HR and OB. Right. But at the very same time, since we are in touch with our academics, so it's very, very important that we know the basic concepts, the basic theories, the basics about statistics, and our focus should be very, very systematic. They should know that, you know, we are confident and we know our topic and we can defend it like very, very, in a very precise manner, I would say.
Right, right. See, because the basic point is ki agar hame apna topic acche se nahi pata, we are not clear about what we actually want to do in the next 3-4 years down the line, that is when we are going to start with our PhD, then how can we actually convince the board? That is a very simple logic.
Yes, okay. Sir.
Now, Navya, that brings me to the last question of our interview, and that is, What is one advice, one suggestion that you would like to give to your future aspirants because they are preparing for both NET as well as PhD?
Yes, sir. So I would say having a systematic approach is very, very important. Having a clear vision is very, very important. Mm-hmm. And sometimes multitasking can go wrong. So in my case, like I stressed upon cracking the UGC NET JRF exam, and then I came up to the process of PhD. So right. Tackling one thing at a time, I would say that it would be preferable. But again, it depends from person to person. If you can handle the pressure, it's great. Right. Apart from that, confidence is the key. And patience is a must, I would say, because this is a long journey. Right. And there might be certain disappointments, but then again, you need to introspect, and maybe next time you can do much better. So having faith in yourself is equally important, I would say.
Right. Absolutely wonderful. So Navya, it was great interacting with you. I'm sure that all of these things that you have shared today is going to be really, really inspiring for all our future aspirants who are going to appear either for NET or for PhD. So thank you so much once again for joining us, and heartiest congratulations once again. I wish you all the best throughout your PhD journey. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, sir.